So we're going to gamify this a little bit so we get proper scoring system, and we'll get that sorted first. So we need to add a variable up here for score. So let's just call it score. And in darts, as you might well know, we start with 501 and we count backwards till we get to zero. This won't be the most accurate representation of it, but it will be close-ish. So what we now need to do is start actually giving scores. So under here, we have a print statement, but that's not actually adding anything to our score. So we need some code which will start counting the score. So if we do score equals score minus 180. So what that will do is that will take 180 from 501 if we get the seconds right. Same thing here, score equals score minus 90 this time. And then likewise here, score equals score minus 50. We don't need anything for that because we're not getting any points. So we obviously want to be able to throw more than one dart. So we want to keep throwing until we get to zero. So we need some kind of loop which is going to do this for us. And we could use an indefinite loop. So if we do this, while score is greater than zero, because zero is when the game is going to end, we want all of this stuff to run. So we just need to now indent all of this because we've made a loop, so it needs to be indented inside the loop. So I'm just going to highlight it all and then command right square bracket or control right square bracket. That will just shift everything over. So that all looks okay. We need as well to count how many darts we're throwing, so we know if we've thrown lots of darts or the least amount of darts. So I'm just going to add a new variable called dart count, and we'll set that to zero because we haven't thrown any darts at the start of the game. And then what we'll need to do is each time we throw the dart, each time we play, we're going to need to add one to the dart counter. So I'm going to go dart count equals dart count plus one. So every time we throw one dart, which is this section, it should add one to the dart counter. And then once we get to zero, we want to drop out the loop, so we unindent. We want to print something like you threw dart count darts. Okay, so that should tell us how many darts we threw. So let's give this a go. I'm just going to knock this value down actually to make the game a bit quicker for the video. So we'll try and get to 200. So let's have a play. Okay, so 2 seconds. Okay, 90. 1 second. 180. We finished. So we threw two darts. So the dart counter is counting the amount of darts we're throwing. So we got to our 200. We got from 200 to zero. And when we got to zero, the loop stopped and the whole game stopped. Drops out the loop and runs this last line of code here. Not classic darts, obviously, because you need to get exactly zero in classic darts, but close enough for the moment.